Welcome to your home school this year, Class 7 Mathematics NCERT or CBSC board. We are in our exercise 2.5. Okay, let's start with your first main. What is your first main heading? Which is greater? So, in this exercise, we are going to see about decimals. Children, as we have seen your decimal part 1, part 2 videos of your mathematics basics. In that clearly given, what is a decimal? What are all introduction part needed for decimals? We have already discussed in that basics. Okay, how it is a decimal and how can we compare, how to arrange the decimal or how to convert the decimal into fraction and all we have seen. Okay, by that knowledge, we are going to start our first main. This is a integer part, decimal point and a decimal value. So here, how can we start compare the decimals now? First, see the whole number part. What do you have here? 0, and here also you have 0. So nothing there to compare. So you shift for the next value in decimal. That is, after point, what do you have here? 5. After point, what do you have? 0. 0 is greater or 5 is greater? Children, compare here. 5 is greater or 0 is greater? 5 is greater, right? First, you try to compare these two. If you are unable to compare any zeros or same values there, then shift to the next value. Now compare 5 and 0. Which is greater? 5 is greater. No need of checking other numbers. It's enough. We have already compared and we got the answer. What is the answer here, children? 0.5 is greater than symbol. This is greater than symbol. 0.05. Is it followed? Now you need to say this. 0, 0. Same there. So shift to the next value in your decimal. 7, 5. Which is greater? 7 is greater, right? So how can you write this one? 0.7 is greater than 0.5. Okay, now next, 7 or 0.7, don't be confused here, only 7, you have to see this value, children. Is 7 greater or 0 greater? 7 is greater, right? So therefore, 7 is greater than 0.7. See the fourth one, 1, 1, same there. Let's move to the next number. 3, 4. Which is greater? 4 is greater. Therefore, what you can say? 1.49 is greater than 1.37. See, your children, the same. You can rewrite in another way. What is that? 1.37 is less than 1.49. Both have the same answer. Which is greater asked? This is greater, we are saying. How can you write? Using less than symbol and also greater than symbol, you can write all these. How? 1.49 is greater than this number. If this is greater means this is lesser, no? With that, I am writing here. Look here. 1.37 is lesser than 1.49. Means 1.49 is greater. Okay? Look here, next one. 2 and 2 in whole number part. Both are same. So shift to the next value. 0, 3. 0 and 3, which is greater? This is greater. So what you can write? 2.30 is greater than 2.03. Last problem here. 0.8 or 0.88. 0, 0. Same. 8, 8, same. So if same, then next value, then what is this? 8. There is nothing here. Nothing here means how you can increase in decimal part. You can increase zeros. How many you want, you can increase. Now see the decimal value here. 0, 8. Which is greater? This is greater. Therefore, what you can write? 0.88 is greater than 0.8. 0.8 simply means 0.80, you can imagine. 8088, which is greater? 88 is greater, right? Second main, express as rupees using decimals. Now we are going to see the conversions here. So what you need to know here? 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. Yes or no? 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. Then what about 1 paisa is equal to how much? How to convert, children? 100 paisa, 1 rupee. Then what about 1 paisa? You can convert this as 1 by 100th rupee. 1 by 100th. This is a decimal value. 100 paisa, 1 rupee means 1 rupee, 1 paisa, how to convert into 1 by 100th rupee. Okay, once again see carefully. 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee. Then 1 paisa is equal to 1 by 100th rupee. Right? So let's see that conversion here. First one, 7 paisa. 1 paisa is how much? 1 by 100. 7 paisa means that equal to 7 by 100. Convert into decimal asked. So using decimals you need to convert. So denominator, how many zeros you have? 2 zeros. When you bring to the numerator, after 2 values you should put the decimal point. That means only I have a single value here. So for that purpose, from this side put 1 zero. Then these 2 zeros, if you want to bring it up, then after 2 values you should keep a decimal point. That is 0.07. Okay, 0.07 rupees. This is the conversion using decimal. So next one, it's not conversion. Okay, so this is the way we express rupees using decimals. Now 7 rupees 7 paise. 7 rupees, how can you write rupees 7 as it is? Plus 7 paise. 7 paise you put here with a plus sign. 1 paise is equal to 1 by 100th rupee. 7 paise is equal to 7 by 100th rupee. So how can you say this one? How can you rewrite in decimal format? 7 by 100 you have seen here now. That is 0.07. This is a rupee symbol, children. So now add. How do you add 7? 0.07. Add this. 7, 0, 7 plus 0, 7 point. Put the point here down. That will be 7 rupees 7 paise. That is 7.07 rupees, you can say. See the third one, 77 rupees 77 paise. So that will be 77 rupees plus 77 paise. Convert, children. 77 by 100. That will be, after converting, what happens this one? Rupees 77 plus 77 by 100, right, in decimal form, 0.77, 0.77 rupees. Add this one, 77, 0.77, like this you should add. Don't add 77 by 77. So this is rupees and this is paise. 7777. Finally, your expression in decimal is 77.77. Okay, see the fourth one here, 50 paise. 50 paise, how can you convert? Rupees, 1 paise, 1 by 100. 50 paise, 50 by 100. 50 by 100. Then this 100, convert here. How to convert? 2 zeros. After 2 values, you put the decimal value. Rupees 0.50 is your answer. Okay, so see the last one, 235 pies. 235 pies means same manner, 1 paisa is equal to, 1 paisa is equal to rupees 1 by 100th. So similarly, 235 by 100 that equal to. So 100, two zeros, after two numbers you should put a decimal point. That makes 2.35 rupees. How do you read this? 2 rupees 35 paise or 2.35 you can say. This is the way we convert into decimal or we express into decimal value. Before starting this third main, just we see there something I have written here. Look here, though you might be knowing, once again have a look. 10 millimeters, mm means millimeter. 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. Where you can see in your scale, right? 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. Then if 1 millimeter means, how will you convert children into centimeter? 1 millimeter, look here. How many zeros you have? 1 0. That zero sent to the denominator. That is 1 by 10 centimeter. 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. 1 millimeter is equal to 1 by 10 centimeter. Next one. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. Then 1 centimeter is equal to how many meters? Here how many zeros are there? 2. Send other side. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter. Listen carefully. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. 1 centimeter is equal to, how will you write in the form of meter means? 1 by 100 meter. Okay, similarly, 1000 meters is equal to 1 kilometer. 1 meter is equal to how many kilometers? How you can write? 1 meter is equal to, how many zeros you have? 3, right? Send other side. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometers. Okay, so next one. 1000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram. It is a weight. 1000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram. 1 gram is equal to how many kilograms? How many zeros are there? 3. 1 by 1000 kilogram. 1 gram is equal to 1 by 1000 kilogram. So once again see this all children. 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. 1 millimeter is equal to 1 by 10 centimeter. Next, 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter. 1000 meters is equal to 1 kilometer. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometers. Next, 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. 1 gram is equal to 1 by 1000 kilogram. Okay, 1 by 1000th kilogram you have to remember. So now, let's start your first problem here. Express 5 centimeters in meter and kilometer. Right? Meter and kilometer. So what do you know children here? So look there. 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter. Right? 1 by 100th meter. So 5 centimeters in meter means 5 centimeter is equal to, just you multiply 5 for this. 5 by 100 meter. That means 5 by 100, how will you write children? 0.2 zeros there. After two values, you should put a decimal. So here, note second value. So I'll write here 0.5. 5, 0, 0. You can place as many you want. So after two values, you should put a decimal point here. So that means 0.05 meter. You can write this 0.05 meter. Next, what is your conversion? 5 centimeters express in kilometer. Express in kilometer. So look there. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 1000 kilometer. Right? So now I need 0.05 meter into kilometer, or you may take 5 centimeter also, children. Already centimeter I have converted into meter. So now meter I will convert into kilometer. That is 0.05 meter. M I will write. Okay. So is equal to here 1 meter means 1/1000. Now 0.05 meter means 0.05/1000 kilometer. That is km. But it's not completed. You need to write it to decimal expression, right? How will you write here? 3 zeros. Denominator, how many zeros you have? 3 zeros. You have to put a decimal point after 3 values, right? So already you have 1 decimal point. Look here carefully. This point, after this you have to see 3 values and put a final point there. Okay, here there will be little confusion will be there for you children. Observe carefully. Okay, 3 zeros you need to put a decimal point. No, 1, 2, 3 you will keep off here. That is wrong. Observe here carefully. Already 1 point there means, see how many numbers you have? 1, 2, right? So 2 zeros already there here. If you want to remove, look here, remove this point and put 2 more zeros. Now count how many zeros you have? 5 zeros. After 5 values you need to put the decimal point. Like that you should see, children, if you have already 1 decimal value in the numerator. Okay, or just you can remove the point and write the zeros at a time. You can write up also, any way you can do. So let me remove these 2 points. Look here carefully. 3 zeros means after 3 places. So I'll remove the point there, 0, 5. I just remove point. But now 3 zeros, 3 values afterwards point. 1, 2, 3 point I need to keep. That is, your answer is 0.00005. Okay, that will be kilometers. 0.00005 kilometer. So most of you people will do mistake here. You will write 0.005 kilometer finished. But never try to do that. Already if you have a point here, after this point you see the numbers and then put the point. Then you can remove this point. Let's see the second question in that. Express 35 millimeter in centimeter. And meter and also kilometer. So let's write first millimeter. You can see there 1 millimeter is equal to how many centimeter? 1 millimeter is equal to 1/10 centimeter. Now convert here. 35 millimeters means 35/10 centimeters. That is, remove this denominator 10. Means only 10. After 1 number you put a decimal point. 3.5 centimeters. Okay, 35 millimeters. How will you convert into centimeter? 3.5 centimeter. Now same you need to convert into meter. Already I have converted into centimeter. Now this value will convert into meter. So look here, 1 centimeter is equal to how many meters? 1/100 meters. That is, 3.5 centimeter is equal to 3.5/100 meters. 3.5 centimeters means 3.5/100 meters. Already point there, children. Neglect this point. Here 2 zeros are there. 2 zeros from here you need to see. That means you don't have another value. Write here 0. That will be 0.35 and your point is here. Yes. Finally your answer 0.035 meters. And still you need to convert into kilometer. Meter to kilometer will convert, children. Look there. 1 meter is equal to 1/1000 kilometer. That will be 0.035 meter is equal to. How will you convert into kilometer? 0.035 by 1000 kilometer. So 0.035 by 1000. How can you convert this? Already point there here, right? From here, three more values, put the decimal point. That means 0.035 already you have a point here, right? From here, three values means only one zero there. So you keep two more zeros. So now, this is already there point. Three values means here. I need to put a point here. So again, one more zero you take. Finally, what is your answer? See, our value is dancing like this. 0.000035 kilometers. So express these conversions carefully. Okay? So don't be confused. So learn that chart carefully and be perfect. Okay? So with this, we are going to end our session, children. In our next class, we are going to complete our exercise. Thank you all.